Strat-O-Matic Excel Carryover League. Brought to you by the Shrimp Troll.
Game 29, Yankees at Twins.
Welcome back, baseball fans. Excuse me, 1972-1975. Carryover League, another opening day in the American League. We got a best of five series between the Yankees and the Twins. The Yankees made the playoffs last year as a wild card team. The Twins just missed out. The Twins probably would have made the playoffs had they been in the National League. American League had a significant advantage to interleague play. But they could not get into the final six. Had the seventh best record in the American League. Battle of turned out to be second place teams a year ago. And in the offseason, the Yankees... Well, they made a deal to get Chris Chambliss away from Cleveland for Fritz Peterson. And didn't add a lot. Kept a lot of their keepers. Kind of in a holding pattern. Don't really expect much out of the Yankees until, you know, Reggie comes along later in the decade. Maybe 76. But we're just not quite there yet with them. They're still competing for the East, though, with Boston, Baltimore. The Twins. They made the loud splash in the offseason. Really getting some really nice improved cards out of Larry Heisel, and particularly this Phil Roof ridiculous card they got. Still got a great bullpen. They still have Burt Blylevin at the top of the rotation. I'm not sure where the Twins are going. We know Killebrew and Oliva are still kicking around, but they're getting up there in years. Kansas City hasn't ascended to the top yet. Neither has the Brewers. It's the Big Bad White Sox in their division. Maybe the Twins are the team that give the White Sox a challenge in the American League Midwest. Today's starting pitchers for your New York Yankees, Mel Stottlemyre. 73-16 game winner, 3.07 ERA, and 273 innings. Probably his last very good season. And for your Twins, it is the 72 Burt Blylevin, a 17-game winner with a 2.73 ERA in 287 innings. Good pitchers. I forgot to mention their one-loss record. All those wins, and they were just 500 pitchers, so there's that. Yankees at Twins in, what the heck's that stadium called? I forgot. Before the Hefty Bag Stadium. Ah, shoot. I used to know that. Anyway, that's where we're at. It's grass. Leading off for the New York Yankees, it is Roy White. 57 is a K. Batting second to DH today, Fred Kendall. 67 is a K. And Bobby Mercer, 62, rolls to first. Bottom of the first, it is Rod Carew. 35 is a base hit for the double-A stealing Carew. We got Munson's -3 arm. Battle Royale here. Let's do it. Let's start the season off and just see what happens here. Hey, he stole a base off the -3 arm of Munson. He's a little ticked off. Bad swipe by Michael on the tag there. And Carew's at second base. Larry Heisel, 32, pops out. Jim Holt, 59, skies the center. And here's Phil Roof, 2-7. That's a base hit to center field. Carew, I'll certainly try it. 17, 18, 19. The arm of Mercer, -2. He slides in. 1-0 Twinkies. Tony Oliva and Dawn, 66, short X. Michael at short to 3-34. He makes the play. Top of two, it's Gene Locklear, 56 is a K. Thurman Munson, 63, pitcher X. Blylevin is an E15. And he surrenders a base hit. Chambliss, his first Yankee at bat, is a 3-6-3 double play. Harmon Killebrew, 66, flies left. Eric Soderholm, 65, pops out. And Joe Lovito, 110, flies to right field. Top of the third, it's Elliot Maddox. 35 is a walk for the C Steeler. Greg Nettles, who's actually a B-hit runner. He's going to hit and run. He's a B-hit and runner. Not normally known for that. I thought Nettles was kind of a free swinger, but I guess not. Hit and run, and the runner will move up successfully. Oh, no. You got to steal a base here. And he steals a base. So Nettles swings through the hit and run. Maddox was going. But he gets in there against the zero armor roof. So they got a runner at second anyway for Nettles. 59 off the Bly Levin card. Double 1-3. Ian gets it. We got a 1-1 tie. The runner at second. Stick Michael. 2-9. There's another base hit to right field. Does Nettles take on the Lovito arm? No, he's not going to do it. Runners on the corners. Infield comes up for A. Bunning Roy White. 6-10. Short X. Craig Robinson's a 3-36. And he makes the play. Runners from first moves up. So you have second and third. Going to keep it up for Fred Kendall. 69 is a sac fly to center field. Runner at second, two outs for Bobby Mercer. Catcher's card. Roof's a 2-6, and the inning's over. 2-0, 2-1. Yankees. Bottom of the third. Craig Robinson, 1-8, grounds a short. Back up top to Carew. 39 is a walk. Larry Heisel, 1-8, is a double 1-10, double. Got runners at second and third, 2-1 lead, they'll play back, Jim Holt. 1-8's a pop out, and with two outs, it's Phil Roof. Let's take a look at the card. He got an RBI singles first up. This Phil Roof card's ridiculous. 126 at-bats, 7 dingers, a 302 average. Best thing about Phil is he stopped batting that year and just stayed where he got that 135 plate appearance and said, you know what, I'm just going to stop right here with a 302 average. No need to go out there and try for a 320. I'm going to have a hell of a Strat-O-Matic card, and he does. My goodness, folks. This is one of the extra player cards that we normally assign to expansion teams, but the Twins are like, man, expansion teams, we need all the help we can get. I mean, we got a tough division. And so Phil Roof stays in Minnesota with this particular card. Here's the pitch. 312 is a K. 2-1 Yankees in the fourth. It is Gene Locklear. 56 is a K. Thurman Munson, 33, lines out. And Chris Chambliss, 66, flies to right. Tony Oliva, 34, first. Killebrew, 27's a K. And Eric Soderholm, 65, pops to second. Go to the fifth. It's Elliot Maddox, 68, base hit. Let's do that thing we tried to do last time, but yeah, let's do it again. Hit and run. And it works! Oh boy, that's the... I don't know if that's the double, because it's not the A. Is it just a single? Yeah, it's a single. Oh, single, not that. We'll take it anyway. Runners on the corners, nobody out. Now they're going to bring it up for Stick Michael. 2-6, and he pops out. Infield up for Roy White. 1-11 is a hit by the pitch, and they're loaded for Fred Kendall. Let's look at the card here for Ground Ball Bees and such. Let's play back and try and get a double play here. Bases loaded, one out. The pitch to Fred Kendall. 36, center B question mark. He had a sac fly last time. He's going to try to run Maddox here. Off the center fielder. Maddox is a 15, 16, 17. Minus a zero arm makes it a 17. And he scores. All right, now you got Bobby Mercer. 1-2 is hit by the pitch again. The bases are reloaded with two outs for Gene Locklear, a 3-1 game. 53, right X. This is Lovito, a 2-10 and right. And he makes the grab, finally. So the Yankees leave him loaded, but they have a 3-1 lead. Bottom of the fifth, let's pause a moment for station identification.
This is the Shrimp Trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
Okay, bottom of the fifth. It is Joe Lovito leading off. Who? Former Ranger, 4-4. Third X, it's Nettles, a 2E22. And he kicks the ball. He throws in the dugout, folks. That's a two-base arrow on Greg Nettles. Normally reliable third baseman. Craig Robinson, skies the center. Back up top to Carew. 2-5, second. We got a runner at third with two outs for Larry Heisel. 2-12, fouls to the catcher. Top of six, it's Munson, 45, right. Chris Chambliss, 6'10", short X. Robinson's a 3E36, and he makes the play. And it's Elliot Maddox, 47 is a K. Bottom of the sixth, two-run game. Jim Holt leads off. 35 is a walk. Your tie run is Phil Roof. He's a 1-5, 6 or 7. 66 is a Skylap. Tony Oliva, 3-6 is a 4. 6-3, double play. That's shame for Oliva there. Let's see. Stottlemyre's a starter 8. Blylevin's a starter 7. They're going to keep it going in a low-scoring 3-1 affair. Greg Nettles. 1-6 round, grounded a second. Stick Michael. 1-5 is a K, and with two outs, it's Roy White. 58, single, and an 18 gets it. Now you got Fred Kendall. 46, second X. Cruz, a 2 at second base, makes the play. All right, actually, the Yankees are going to do some defensive trickery here. Get some better gloves out there to protect this two-run lead. We're going to get Swoboda and Alomar in here. So Roy White will leave left field where he's not very good for Swoboda. And Fred Kendall will leave. Alomar will go to second base. The second baseman will go into right field. And the right fielder, Gene Locklear, will go to DH and bat in the eighth inning. So, the Yankees have improved their defense in two spots. Stretch time here in Minnesota, down 3-1. We are enjoying the brilliant Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes. Teddy Pendergrass, wake up, everybody. You know how to make me feel so good. That's what we're hearing. Wake up, everybody. Don't leave me this way. Yeah, great stuff there. 1975, one of the years in the timeline. Bottom of the seventh. Stottlemyre's a starter 8. Yankees, amazing bullpen. Not good, not great. Amazing bullpen. Sparky Lyle, Fred Bean, Lenny McDaniel, Heidi their powers, plus Luke Walker. Okay, not amazing. Almost amazing minus Luke Walker. Bottom of the seventh. It is Harmon Killebrew. 48 is a base hit. Tying run is Soderholm. 64 pops out. Joe Lovito, 48, and there we go, double 1-3, base hit. We got runners on the corners for number 9 hitter, Craig Robinson, playing back with a 2-run lead. 2-9 is a fielder's choice, so they conceded a run. They could have brought it up and stopped that from happening. They left it back. Robinson beat the throw to first, and it's a 3-2 game for Rod Carew. 2-5, grounds out. Into the eighth we go. Blylevin will continue. It's Bobby Mercer. 37's a walk. Gene Locklear, 47's a K. Munson, 6'10", third X. This is a 2-3rd baseman. Eric Soderholm's a 2E22. That's a double play. A couple bad innings out of Blylevin. Trails 3-2, bottom of the eighth. The battle reaches, we might hook Stottlemyre so he can't lose. Give him a little protection there. It'll be Larry Heisel leading off. 2-8 is a grounder to short. Jim Holt. 4-11. First X. This is Chambliss. 3-13. Some years he's a 2. That's going to be a single, though. And now it's the dangerous Phil Roof, and you don't want to do that. We're going to go 7 1/3. You don't want to have Babe Ruth-like homers walking into the batter's box, dare we say it. Jeez, my goodness. Nope, Sparky Lyle is coming in the 8th, potential 5-out save. 9-5, 192 ERA, his first year away from the Red Sox. Traded for Danny Cater, I believe. 108 innings, 1972. Will he go for a 5-out save? Possibly. They also have excellent Fred Bean and McDaniel, so I don't know. Holt is a decent base runner at first. And I think they might just go to Mitterwald here. Yeah. George Mitterwald. He catches versus left-handed pitching. He will be the pinch hitter here for Phil Roof with runner at first. The pitch to Mitterwald. 37 is a K. And with two outs, it's Tony Oliva who hits lefties very well. So he will swing. Tony Oliva, here we go. 38 is a roller to first. And the Twins leave men on in the 7th and 8th innings of a 3-2 affair. We go to the 9th. Quick game today. Blylevin's very good against lefties, which is why we thought he would do well against a lefty-heavy lineup of the Yankees. He's got Chambliss, Nettles, and Stick Michael coming up this inning. Here is Chris Chambliss. 67's a K. Elliot Maddox, 58, is going to get a hit. It's going to be a double. He has reached three times today. Greg Nettles, 49. That is a strikeout. Right-handed batter would have better luck on that particular pitch. And with two outs, it's Stick Michael. 6'11", pitcher X, Blylevin. Can you field your position? He's an E15. That should be... No, he makes an error. Oh, my. So the inning continues. Should be over. You got runners in the corners. But you got Sandy Alomar in the top spot as a defensive replacement. Here's the pitch to Sandy. 1-7 is a K, and Blylevin gets out of it. And here we go, bottom of the 9th. The Twins. Oh, boy, you got Killebrew crushes lefties. Soderholm, not so much. Next two guys, not much either. Might have to tie it with the first swing here. Let's take a look at Harmon Killebrew before he steps in the box in the bottom of the 9th. Old Harmon, his last really productive year with the Twins in 72. 26 homers, 231 average, just 13 doubles, but 94 walks. Still gets a lot of walks, and teams are still scared to pitch to him. I would be too. But Sparky Lyle is muscling up. Here is the pitch. 55 is a strikeout. Now you got Eric Soderholm. 46 off of Lyle is a base hit. Now you get the bottom two spots, and these guys are not good. Levito and Craig Robinson. If you go Chico Cardenas, they'll immediately go to a righty since Chico doesn't have any hits on this card. So, you could just do the double pinch hit, but then, do they have a second lefty in the bullpen? They're not going to go to it. So, which two batters do you want to face against a righty? Let's do that. So, this is what's going to happen. Chico Cardenas is going to be added as a pinch hitter here. And they're not pitching to him because he hits like 330 against left-handed pitching. I told you these Twins. They got Heisel and Roof tearing it up. And this Chico Cardenas against lefties is ridiculous. But he's not going to bat here. They're going to pull, like I said, that great bullpen, unselfish bullpen. They're going to pull the 192 ERA of Sparky Lyle and bring in the 168 ERA of Fred Bean. Fred Bean's going to try and get the final two outs with a runner at first. So we're going to need another pinch hitter because Chico Cardenas has nothing on his card, which is why they have Ron Woods, the last guy on the bench, who has power versus righties. Ron Woods, 10 home runs and 220 at-bats with a Spos in 72. Decent chance to win the game right here. On the roll of a 3-6. Let's take a look at the Ron Woods card. You see, you're not going to get Chico Cardenas with that high batting average, but you're going to get Ron Woods with a reasonable chance at a home run here. So Fred Bean is all warmed up and ready to go. The tie run, Sutter home at first. The win run here, Ron Woods in the box. And here is the pitch to Ron Woods. 55 off of Bean is short X. This is Stick Michael, a 334, pretty mediocre shortstop. And it's a ground ball C. So we got a runner in scoring position with two outs. And we put the game in the hands of Craig Robinson. But you know what? Let's take a look at him. He's not awful. I mean, his batting average is, he's a 226 hitter. But he's not going to play against left-handed pitchers. They're daring the Yankees to pull Fred Bean for Luke Walker. Yeah. But let's face it, folks. Rod Carew's on deck. So this is the guy you're dealing with right here. Craig Robinson with a runner on second and two outs in the bottom of the ninth. Here's the pitch. 1-6, Craig Robinson delivers. Double 1-7. That's a base hit and the Twins tie it up with Carew on deck. Pick your poison. they picked the Craig Robinson poison and blew up on him. We got a 3-3 tie. And you got Rod Carew in the box. Here's the pitch to Rod. 38 is a fly ball to right field. Bonus baseball opening day in Minnesota. The little Twins get runs in the 7th and 9th. Almost another one in the 8th. Can't quite pull off the victory in regulation. They need some more time. They have an outstanding bullpen. The Yankees do too, but they already lost Sparky Lyle for the day. I think they're going to go Tom Murphy here. Tom Murphy, the new Twin closer. He was a Brewer in 74 with 10 wins, a 190 ERA, and 123 innings. The Twins have always had good bullpens in my Strat leagues. Always. Going back to Stan Williams and Ron Paranowski and Pete Reichert and Bill Campbell. And now Tom Murphy's doing well. So, I mean, they just... And then Doug Corbett in the late 70s, early 80s. I mean, Twins just know how to do their relief, the relief thing. And now Murphy, relief three, will be asked to go three. In the top of the 10th, looks like both benches are toast. Well, no, the Yankees have some more players. They have Bernie Allen on the bench. But in the 10th, it will be Bobby Mercer leading off. 69, skies the center. Gene Locklear, 56, flies to right and with two outs. Munson, 2-5, base hit. Now you got Chambliss. 1-3, rolls to second base. Well, the good news for the Yankees is at least their great relievers can pitch long. Fred Bean's a relief four with the aforementioned 168 ERA. And then when he runs out of gas, I could just bring in Lenny McDaniel, who's a relief four, with a 281 ERA. So I'm good for about 18 innings here. here we go, folks. Bottom of the 10th, it'll be Larry Heisel leading off. 5'11", second X. This is Mr. Alomar. Brought in as a defensive replacement a couple innings ago. Alomar is a 2E19. It's a base hit off the two second basemen. Great break. Heisel's an ace stealer. I don't think... Yeah, they're not going to steal off of Munson, but why not try hit and run here with Jim Holt? He's a B hit and runner. Let's try it. It's a base hit on the hit and run five right there, folks. And the Twins got them. Runners on the corners, nobody out with Mitterwald, Tony Oliva, and Harmon Killebrew. A couple legends in there. The Yankees bring their infield up, and it will be George Mitterwald. Not a lot you can do here with the infield up. Here's the pitch to Mitterwald. 4-4, homer, 1-9, double the rest, and it's gone! George Mitterwald, plenty of power. 3-run bomb in the bottom of the 10th, and the comeback is complete by the Twins. Heck of a game. 6-3 final. Tom Murphy gets the win, and it's Fred Bean who gets the loss. We'll give you the box score of this game and the results of the rest of the video, the rest of the series at the end of the video, so stay tuned. Well, baseball fans, here's your box score from game one. The Twins coming back with some late lightning out of unlikely sources. Craig Robinson with a game-tying hit in the ninth and a George Mitterwald homer in the tenth. 6-3 victory for the Twins. Very impressed, are we, with their gritty play, something they've been lacking in recent years. Game two in Minnesota, it's going to be a battle between Jim Cott for the Twins and Doc Medich for the Yankees. Low-scoring affairs is the key of this series. Bottom of the fourth inning, you get a couple singles and a ground ball scores a run. In the sixth inning, again, singles by Holt and Oliva and a sack by Killebrew. It's two runs for the Twins. Minnich would only give up those two runs on seven hits. But the story is Jim Kittycott pitching out of jams, doing a great job. Gets a CGSO Jim Cott. Five hitter, two walks, two Ks. Yankee offense in a funk. They drop two straight in Minnesota. So they have to come back to Yankee Stadium for Game 3 to avoid a sweep. Oh boy, folks. Here we go. Game 3 Yankee Stadium starters. Dave Goltz, a righty, very young Dave Goltz. Real good against righties, pretty weak against lefties. And the Yankees load up with eight lefties against them. Versus Mike Kekich, a lefty starter for the Yankees, the weakest link in their pitching staff. We expect an 8-7 affair. Not at all, actually, what happened. The fourth inning, the Twins get a lead, three singles, the third of which by Mr. Mitterwald again, 1-0. Bottom of the sixth inning, they finally get the Goltz in an unlikely way. Two base hits, then an error by shortstop Chico Cardenas and a sac fly. The game's tied at one. Top of the seventh, an Eric Sauter home double, RBI single by Carew, and the Twins have a 2-1 lead. Bottom half of the inning, we have a single, and then a base hit off of Carew's glove, who's a two-second baseman. Doesn't really matter, though, folks. It's a single's a single. And then you get an RBI single by Munson, the dreaded catcher's X PB plus foul out, and the Yankees finally get a lead, 3-2. It looks like the Yankees going to win this, pull this thing out. Kekich leaves after six, five hits on a run. They bring Lindy McDaniel in. He gives up a run in two innings. Then in the ninth inning, it's Sparky Lyle to get the, should be a easy save. He gets Mitterwald to ground out. Jim Holt flies the center. Eric Soderholm singles to keep the game alive. Then with two outs, all he needs to do is get Ron Woods out. Ron Woods, former member of the Expos, the latest hero for the Twins. Two-run homer in the top of the ninth inning, and the Twins are going bananas in the dugout. They got a 4-3 lead. No one saw this coming. And Bill Campbell, one of three capable closers, Pete Reichert, Tom Murphy, and Bill Campbell, finishes the game to the stunned dismay of Yankee Stadium Boobird fans. The Yankees get swept by the unlikely Twins. We had a very good draft. Who knows, folks? The late inning magic they displayed pull in victory out of the jaws of defeat. Maybe the Twins are this year's Cinderella. Maybe. Break up your Minnesota Twins. They sweep the Yankees. Three games straight. And we'll see you next time.